Hello everybody and welcome to episode number 8 of our Swansea Career Mode, competitive career mode with the other YouTubers. Remember to go check out their episodes as well. Their final episodes are going to be probably pretty amazing. As you guys can see though, we're only sitting 6 points back of Chelsea for top of the league, so I felt like maybe we could actually go on to maybe win the Premier League title. But with a 2-0 loss to Tottenham and a 1-1 draw with West Ham, not doing that any justice. Not really looking that way, but we did get a 1-0 win in the Europa League first leg against Sevilla, which I actually messed that up. It was actually supposed to be Monaco, but I ended up not saving, so it ended up being Sevilla. But we got a good first leg scored there, and as you guys can see though, not a good start against Liverpool here. And again, I mean, I feel like we controlled this game against Liverpool, but again, just not scoring first, but we did manage to get on the scoreboard. N'Golo Kante putting it in the back of the net there for 1-1, and that was actually how the game would finish, is 1-1. And I mean, I felt like I was in control of the game, but I just could not put in the back of the net. But we did have the second leg against Sevilla, and oh my goodness, talk about probably worst games of the series so far. This is definitely one of them, the game against Sevilla. I mean, there's nothing happened in this game. These are literally the best chances of the game. The goalkeeper clearing it off his line is pretty much, it's made the highlight reel. That's how boring this game was. This is really the only chance of the game. Sigurdsson gets in on goal here. He puts it across and tries a shot and ends up being blocked and ends up falling to Cavani, who kicks it straight at the goalkeeper. And that was literally the only thing that came up in the highlight reel, was that shot that was saved by the goalkeeper. It wasn't even that impressive, but it was enough for us to get through to the next round of the Europa League, and we did get a 3-1 win against Newcastle, jumping into the first leg against Wolfsburg, a 1-1 draw. Feeling pretty good about that. I mean, a 1-1 draw isn't too bad at home. I would have liked to get a few more goals, but we had to go to Wolfsburg then to play the second leg, and getting late on in the first half here is a good turn in the box and a great finish from Bas Dost, making it 1-0 Wolfsburg. And this was just really poor defending from Swansea. I just felt all over the place, but we weren't done there. 87th minute, all looked done for us, but it's Edinson Cavani, the man, the myth, the legend, making it 1-1 here in the dying embers of the game, and looks like he's going to be sending it to extra time, as the first leg ended 1-1 as well, so we needed extra time to try and solve this game, bringing on a few subs there. Jumping into this one, and it's a lovely, lovely bit of play from Wolfsburg, and it ends up in the back of the net as a backwards header from Julian Draxler, which is just an absolute strange goal for me to concede there, and ends up being in the back, and that was pretty, I was actually really upset when conceding this goal, because it just seemed to me just so unrealistic that Julian Draxler is going to try a back header and it's going to somehow chip Fabianski, but it ended up going in the back of the net 2-1. At this point, I was pretty much just losing my head, and I make a stupid challenge with Grimes, and it ends up being a red card. We're down to 10 men, all look done, but no, it's the man, the myth, the legend, Edinson Cavani. He cuts inside, smashes it in the back of the net, making it 2-2, and those two away goals would actually be enough to send us through to the next round of the Europa League, to the semi-finals, and now we actually only have two more games to play for, and maybe we'll be even in the Europa League final. And I mean, I felt so excited about this goal from Cavani, because I thought everything was done there, but we ended up getting those two goals and leveling the game. And that is actually the first leg of the next round of the Europa League against Arsenal. We ended up getting a 0-0 draw at home. Not a horrible result, but we jumped into this game against Everton and still trying to fight for that Premier League title. I mean, it's all still up for grabs, and it's still 0-0, but we do get the goal. Actually, Lord Bentner actually playing for Everton this game, which was pretty awesome. I didn't really show him, but he didn't do enough here. So is N'Golo Kante making it 1-0 for Swansea, and this is a good chance here. Edinson Cavani, 1-on-1. He slots it by the goalkeeper, late on with only 15 minutes, putting this game pretty much out of reach, in my opinion. And yeah, another goal for Cavani, our top scorer for Swansea this season. He just looks so good. And this is a pretty poor bit of play from Phil Jagielka, who is actually one of the best defenders in the Premier League, statistically anyway. And he gives away the ball poorly, and a bit of a sweaty display there as we tramp it over to Edinson Cavani. He makes it 3-0 Swansea, and we're back to our old way, scoring tons and tons of goals. And I mean, Everton were actually sitting second in the league, joint with us at the time, so we ended up going above them. But then we jump into the second leg here against Arsenal. This is a big game. We do need to at least get a goal to take the lead, but it was Arsenal who got things going first with a lovely little bit of play here. Alexis Sanchez going far down to put the Gunners up 1-0 on aggregate. And in the game, and I mean, all we needed was a one away goal, and so I wasn't feeling too threatened by this, because all we needed was another away goal, and we'd be actually on top with the away goal rule. But it wasn't to be. A poor touch there in the box from Jordi Amat, and it falls to McElneny. He makes it 2-0 Arsenal, and this game was out of reach. I mean, I just could not get anything going in the Arsenal area. All my shots were just kind of outside, nothing really too threatening, and Arsenal get a lucky break there as Jordi Amat controls it right to McElneny. He puts it in the back of the net, 4-2 for a 2-0 lead for Arsenal, and they end up going through. So we are out of the Europa League. And I mean, we did a pretty good run. We made it to the final four anyway, which was pretty good. And then going into the final month of the season, we were still only a few points behind Chelsea, and we needed to pick up every possible point, but two draws against Crystal Palace and Middlesbrough, who were actually in the relegation zone, kind of screwed us over at the end of the day. But we did jump in the final game of the Premier League season against, well, West Bromwich Albion, and a good start there as Conte goes 1-on-1 with the goalkeeper. He slots it in the back of the net and gives us the early lead. Just before halftime, though, again, as this time it's Andre Ayew, and he just cuts in, and it was just a lovely finesse finish. Top corner, making it 2-0 Swansea. And I felt really good. I felt really confident we were going to go on to end this game and end the series on a high note. And that's exactly what we did. Again, Andre Ayew in on goal. He makes it 3-0 Swansea. And that's, I just wanted to end the season on a high. And this is exactly what I gave in this final game. It was just a lot of goals, and that's exactly what I wanted. And this time it's Edinson Cavani. Looking at it, he's going to try and score, and this time another sweaty tramp. I'm sorry. I mean, that's 2-2 games. I'm really sorry. But yeah, it is 4-0 Swansea. And I felt really good about this game, because we were going to end the season with a good result. And we weren't even done there. Andre Ayew, though, cutting inside. And it falls to him really nicely for his hat trick. He puts it in the back of the net. Andre Ayew, a guy who's been with us since the beginning, getting his hat trick in the final episode. It just felt really right to me anyway. And it was a really well-deserved hat trick. But West Bromwich weren't quite done. They didn't just sit down and let us thrash them, as they did pull one back. But Andre Ayew was my man of the match, gaining a 9.8 rating. Anyways, though, guys, as you can see, that is going to be the end of the season. 38 games played. We sit second in the Premier League with Swansea, so not a bad result. But anyway, though, guys, I just want to thank everyone who followed this series, anyone who came from anybody else's channel, and all the guys, all the other YouTubers as well that were in this series. So I just want to thank them for letting me into the series and just to enjoy it. I really did enjoy it, and hopefully we can do something like this in the future as well. And yeah, so just remember to go check them out. Their links will be in the description down below. And yeah, we'll come back hopefully with another video next Wednesday about kind of how we did and just kind of talking to each other and just, maybe a compilation of goals and stuff like that. Hopefully that'll be all about around next Wednesday. But anyway, though, hope you guys enjoy this episode, and until next time, take care.